Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another normal-sized episode of Stone Block. Isn't that right, normal-sized Venom?
It sure is normal-sized Thermite.
All right, so come here. I need you to come up here. All right. All right, so we did a little bit in between. Well, we did a lot of bit in between episodes. So we're going to do our best to go over that. But first, today's goal is power. We got to get more power going because we kind of are starting to max out the thing. So I'm thinking we're going to use the, what is it called? We're going to be using the whatever mod this is. I have no idea. And apparently we have an Ender Cell, which that could be useful. So now we have some XP jelly babies. All right, we'll put those in there. We need to make these things, and we need to learn this mod because I actually don't know anything about this mod, so we're going to be learning it together today. But first, I think we should go over everything we did in between the episodes. Isn't that correct?
I would have to agree.
Okay. First thing we did was we made a little bit more of the water wheels just so we could get as much power as we needed because we really wanted to get our storage up, and as you can see, we got it up. That was your doing, wasn't it?
I did get it up. I finally got it up.
Yeah, I'm just going to ignore that comment. Okay, so back here, things got a little complicated. If you see this stuff, or I think last episode we were talking about like trying to get our resources to get to a certain number and then just stop once they're there. That's what this does. So basically, you know what? Actually, I'm just going to make one really quick so I can show you guys how it works. All right, so basically for this, all you need to do is have it connected with a cable. Everything looks so. I'll get to it soon. So you just need to connect. You just need to connect a cable to your crafting grid, and just anywhere. And that cable just needs to touch. So as long as there's a cable, you take your little trash can boy, because that's where it gets deleted, and then you export that. You throw an exporter into that, and then you take your detector. Boom. All right. So that's all you need. Now you got to just decide what item we want. Okay, we can do coal. And we didn't do coal already, correct? We have glass, iron, quartz, and redstone. That's all the stuff we're producing a lot of. And we are producing a lot of coal. So basically, this is your filter slot. You just put this in here. And I think, yeah. You want to set it to redstone mode to where it only works with a redstone signal. And then in here, you also set the item you want. And basically, we don't want anything more than 2,000 coal. So that's our number. And then you change the mode to emit signal when above this amount. So basically it's saying when it's above 2,000, it puts a redstone signal. And that redstone signal tells this thing to export coal into our trash can. Once our coal gets to over 2,000, like it is now, it's not going to go any higher. So it's going to sit at that number, and once it gets a little higher, it'll just send it to the trash if it's over 2,000. And then we got this stuff is a mess. I'm going to do my best to explain it. I'm going to do it really fast just so you can maybe understand it. So this is our furnace. We import coal with a importer somewhere. Yeah, we import coal. No, wait, not the importer. We export coal through the side right here, I think. We fuel input somewhere with this exporter. And then we import quartz as well. Export. I don't know. All the terms are super confusing. Basically, this thing checks if we have less than 500 silicone. And then it tells this thing to put quartz in here to smelt, and then it exports the quartz. And then, yeah, this thing just is coal, and then it works. Just trust me. All right, and then we got this bad boy right here. This is our beautiful creation. When we upgraded our storage, we needed lots of the processor stuffs. So we made this, which automatically does our processor stuff for us, sort of automatically. And it has three of these little deployers automatically going, and then silicone, redstone, blah, blah, blah. So this one you just fill up with redstone. This one we just filled up with silicone. And then this one we fill up with whatever processor we're trying to make. And then we just put our processor bindings in here. And then it will slowly... Is this going the right way? This is going the wrong way. All right, this should fix it. Yeah, there we go. Okay, now it's spinning the right direction. I don't know what happened. So basically, it just takes these things out of the chest and then puts them here, and then they just bop, and then it puts it into the chest, and then that gets piped into the smelter thingy, and then it smelts it, and then it imports it into our system over there. So yeah, that's it. That's just all the changes we kind of did in between episodes. Hello, little guy. Are you lost? Do you need help finding the bathroom? We got to get some power going. We got our alternator spinning a little bit faster in between episodes. That was the water wheel. to get it to go into 90 FE per tick, but we need more. We need lots more power. Show me the energy. Okay, time. It's power time. And since I don't really know exactly how to use this mod, whatever we make first is just going to be what we kind of go with. So we have a thermogenerator, which generates FE from furnace fuels. Okay, it gets up to some pretty good speeds, but so our other option is to make a Okay, so let's get this thing. Boom. How does this guy work? I think we put lava in it and it generates energy. So I'm assuming let's actually upgrade it first. Because I guess we should. Okay, so that is an upgraded one. Can we upgrade it even more? What is that? Energized steel. Huh. Energizing. All right, we'll get to this eventually. So now we need a good way to make lava. And I'm thinking, I looked at this before the episode, and I'm thinking the best way might be to either do it like this, or use the, I saw it. Is it magma crucible? I think the magma crucible might be the way to go. Okay, so here's the magma crucible. That seems like it should be everything we need, maybe. All right, I'm changing my mind. Magma crucible is definitely not the way to go. That was a big waste of time. Considering we need the power already to make the lava, we're gonna go with the create way to make lava. And that we need a blaze burner. Can we make that off the bat? We can, okay. I'm gonna come meet you over there. I'll see you there soon.
Me?
Oh, I found it. All right. I think I just kidnap you.
Excuse me, sir. Skeleton.
You're coming home with me. Let me out. Let me out. Okay. All right. We got to annihilate some blazes. All right. You do that work. I got to check some stuff real quick. All right. After more research, I have decided that the blaze burner also will not work.
Why is that?
Because you need lava to make it work as well. I messed up on that. As well.
Why can't we make lava?
Because we're trying to make lava and we can't use lava to make lava. That's the problem. What the heck is a lava chicken? What does that do? We should probably just make a lava chicken.
Probably makes lava if I had to guess.
But how does it make lava? Oh, the chicken makes the lava eggs. That was used with a bucket to make lava buckets. I'm thinking we can do this. This might take me a second to set up, but it's gonna work. Oh, you got a bit of arrows inside you, buddy. What are those boots? You get some new Nikes while you're
out? Look at this.
Woo! Oh, are you bouncy? Are those like slime boots? Oh, I think we have some of those. Interesting.
Woo!
Here's what I'm thinking. We can take the eggs from the lava chicken and put them into this ender chest. This is a yellow one, so it's a completely separate. That way things don't get confusing. And then we're going to run it all the way over to here. And hopefully, if we do that, it'll take the eggs and put them into there. It does. Okay. All right. You know what? I have another method we're going to try. I don't like this one. I can't figure it out. Maybe this will work. Okay, that's not the desired strategy. All right, let's see what we can do with this. All right, now we just disconnect those, and then this one should fill up with the egg when it gets it. Let's put the eggs back in here. Okay, so it sets the egg there, and then all we have to do, I keep getting these lava buckets, go in there. And then we put this there, and it should craft into a lava bucket. Okay, cool. Now if we do this, does this mean it'll go down, or will it pop? So I think if we put a bucket in here, it should... Oh, no, it doesn't. This is maybe not the best idea for it. We have a deployer. Deploying lava buckets is not always the best idea, but we'll see what happens. This is getting confusing so fast. Okay, what if we put the lava bucket in its hand? Okay. Oh, I'm feeling this. This is gonna work. I know it. What do you think, Venom?
I think it might work. Oh, it did work.
It's taking the lava out, though, after it deploys it.
Oh.
Okay. I figured this a situation like this might happen, so I came up with a counter to it. Oh, wait, we only need one pipe. Okay. So, now, here's the goal. So, if we use this... Okay, nice. But now we can go into here and get this filter on it. And then we need this to be a regular bucket. And then we add bucket. Submit. Oh, this better work. Okay. So if there's an empty bucket, it'll filter it out and put it back in there. But if it's a lava bucket, it won't. And then this should take it and put it into here, which it's not doing. I think it just puts it into the inventory of the thing below it. Oh, it does. Okay, cool. Okay, so now we just need to do that. We should just have to do it like this. And then that'll... Oh! Oh! Oh, gosh! So now all we have to do is take this and go into here. I want to break this when there's no lava. Grab it, grab it. Oh, jeez. So if the bucket's empty, it'll grab it. And then put it into the crafter. And craft a lava bucket. It's doing it.
Ooh.
That's so perfect. Okay. So now we just have a thing that's generating lava. One way or another, it's complete. This is such a mess, but it works. I'm glad it works. So basically, if you hatch the lava eggs and you export them into the crafter and you craft them with an empty bucket, take that bucket, makes a lava bucket, and then we're deploying it onto the magma tor, and it should be generating energy. It's got 80,000 kilo-fe, which is good. I think. All we should have to do is... Oh yeah, that's gonna keep the lava... Oh my gosh, this is gonna be so good. So we just keep upgrading this guy. Oh no. Where did the thing go? Oh no, did I incinerate it? Oh, it's gone. Alright, at least it wasn't that hard to get that again. Okay, and now we just need this one. Oh gosh, how do we get this energized steel? We got it energizing it, which... This is getting so complicated so fast. So how do we use this guy? Oh no, we're not generating power anymore. Okay, so if we take our energizing rod right here... Okay, let's set this guy back here and then do this and then this. Is getting power now. It is. Cool. And then I think this thing said it's supposed to get this power wirelessly. Which I don't really... I don't know how to tell if it's getting power or not, but we're gonna assume it is.
Oh. Oh.
Are you doing something?
It did the thing!
It did the thing.
It worked exactly how I thought it was going to.
Oh. Yeah, this is something we might need to set up an automation for. But let's just get what we need now to upgrade this thing. We need 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 minimum to get it. Okay, now we got the next one. All right, cool. How is the next one after that? Blazing crystal. You just energize blaze. So that one should be easy. Do we have a bunch of blaze yet? Okay, there we go. Now we got the tier 4 or whatever number it was. And then turn that on. Okay, and we're still generating lava faster than it takes it, which is real nice. All right, just swapped out to a better chicken, so we're definitely producing it fast enough now. So dang, we went from 90 to producing 890 now. So we're chugging some stuff now. I don't know why this one's not working. Do you have to, like, bind them together somehow? Do you know? All right, well, that's a pretty good power generating system. What do you think?
It seems like a pretty cool...
Oh, okay. Alright, yep, yeah. That's the end of the episode. We're done on that. Hey, look, I got a cape now. I don't know how I got it, but look at... Hey, can you see it? Look at my fancy cape. It's waving in the wind. Alrighty, well, I think that's gonna do it for episode 7 of Stone Block. I hope you guys enjoyed. I will see you next time. Bye-bye.